Would you like to have the gift of knowing exactly what's going to happen to yourself and the whole world years from now? You can say, no thanks, I'll pass. But Nostradamus, easily the most famous future teller ever, didn't have that luxury. Or did he? Was he a great seer or just a scam artist? To answer that question, let's first go back to the beginning. Before the great astrologer and physician had earned his one-name fame as just Nostradamus, he was Michel de Nostredame, born in Saint-Rémy-de-Provence in the south of France in 1503. Growing up, little Michel had his grandfather, Jean de Saint-Rémy, as a tutor, who taught him Latin, Greek, Hebrew, and math from an early age. When he turned 14, the future seer entered the University of Avignon to study medicine. Yeah, at 14! An outbreak of bubonic plague interrupted his studies, and he turned to herbal remedies and started working in the countryside. Over the next several years, Nostradamus treated plague sufferers with some pretty progressive methods for his time. He told his patients to keep good hygiene, follow a low-fat diet, and get plenty of fresh air. He also created a rose pill packed with vitamin C, which provided some relief for mild cases. He also got married during this time, but his family, sadly, didn't make it through the plague. In 1538, Nostradamus left Provence and spent the next several years traveling. It's believed that he had a psychic awakening exactly during this time. Legend has it that he was able to pick out the future Pope Sistus V from a group of monks when he saw them in Italy. He eventually went back to France, married a rich widow, and had six kids with her. A few years later, he started meditating a lot and moved from medical science to the more supernatural. In 1550, Nostradamus created his first almanac with predictions for the upcoming year. It instantly became a hit in France. In 1555, his Les Prophéties, or The Prophecies, came out. It became Nostradamus's most famous book and a bestseller for centuries to come. The book was written in 942 quatrains, or four-lined rhymes, and combined Greek, Italian, Latin, and Provençal, his native dialect of French. It was maybe thanks to the fact that the predictions were so obscure and didn't relate to black magic that people and authorities of that time were willing to hear what he had to say. He even managed to gather some fans. In fact, Catherine de' Medici, the wife of King Henri II, invited him to Paris to come up with horoscopes for her kids. Still, there were those who didn't like what Nostradamus was doing and considered it some sort of evil sorcery. So, is that what it really was? Nostradamus himself explained that he based his predictions on astrology, the practice of calculating where the planets and stars find themselves in relation with the Earth. He also used medieval chronicles and quoted Plutarch, for instance. According to Oxford scholar and famous Nostradamus translator Erica Cheatham, he took some ancient prophecies, including ones from religious texts, correlated them with astrology, and used them to predict the future. Most professional astrologers of his time didn't quite support his methods, as they were positive you can't use horoscopes to predict the future. According to the official version, Nostradamus passed away on July 2, 1566, after having suffered from gout, arthritis, and edema for many years. Some scholars believe he even knew of his own death because he told his secretary, Jean de Chavigny, the evening before that he wouldn't find Nostradamus alive at sunrise. Whoa, that's pretty crazy. Centuries after his death, Nostradamus's predictions still attract a lot of public attention and have become the topic of research, discussion, and of course, heated debate. Let's see which of his most famous predictions came true, at least according to his supporters. 1. The death of Henry II. Translators of Nostradamus' work are positive that he predicted the tragic death of his contemporary, King Henry II, in one of these quatrains. He talks about a young lion fatally wounding the older one on the battlefield by piercing his eye through a golden cage. Well, in the summer of 1559, a jousting tournament was held to celebrate the wedding of King Henry II's daughter, Gabrielle, Comte de Montgomery, who was younger than Henry, sent his lance right through the king's headgear and into his eye. He didn't survive his injury. It was actually this prediction that gained Nostradamus some fame during his time. Number 2. The Great Fire of London. Nostradamus mentioned that London will be burnt through lightning of 23s the 6. The Great Fire of London happened a century after Nostradamus' time, on September 2, 1666. 20 multiplied by 3 is 60, and if you add 6 to it, you get 66. The fire wasn't caused by lightning, though. One little spark in a bakery on a hot summer day started the fire that engulfed the entire city. The Great Donut Fire? Number 3. The French Revolution. The prophecy supposedly predicted the French Revolution as well, mentioning that enslaved populace, songs, chants, and demands will take control while princes and lords are held captive in prisons. 2 centuries after Nostradamus, the storming of the Bastille took place in 1789, and a new republic was established in France. Quite a lot of aristocrats were, in fact, imprisoned. 4. Napoleon's Conquest. Nostradamus' supporters say he mentioned Pas-Ney-Loran, where the great man hurries to the confluence. Pas-Ney and Loran are 3 towns in France. The name of the last of them is actually Oloron, but Nostradamus supposedly wrote it like that to make an anagram. When you put the 3 names together, you get Napoleon Roy, which sounds a lot like Napoleon the King in French. 5. Louis Pasteur. Humankind can thank Louis Pasteur for the discovery of vaccination and microbial decay. Actually, it's where we get the process and term for pasteurization. In his writings, Nostradamus mentioned that the lost thing is discovered, hidden for many centuries, and Pasteur will be celebrated by the people. Now, all of that sounds pretty convincing, right? So it's no wonder why Nostradamus supporters consider every little detail in his quatrains as proof that he was a great seer and genius. It's still impossible to say if he really was some future teller or just a crafty mind trying to make some money connecting prophecies with astrology. Remember, he sold some really popular books. Skeptics point out that there are practically no specific dates mentioned in his writings, and the mix of languages he was using, especially the Old French, make them pretty hard to translate accurately. Some books and websites even say he used a secret code language or anagrams from modern English. So there's a lot of room for speculation and discussion. According to Dr. Michael Shermer, a science historian and founder of the Skeptic Society, looking for hidden meanings and patterns is just in human nature. Our brain simply evolved to connect the dots of our world. This could partially explain Nostradamus' popularity and all the hype around his predictions. Those who don't share this excitement also like to point out that Nostradamus supporters normally use events of the past to prove he was right. That is, they only find explanations in his writings for events that have already passed. Besides, not all his predictions were spot on. One example of a big mistake he made was his foreseeing the end of the world in 1999. Some people say he was referring to a comet strike. Others think it was the rogue planet Nibiru that, thankfully, never did crash into our planet. All he wrote was, "The year 1999, 7 months, from the sky will come a great king of terror, to bring back to life the great king of the Mongols, before and after Mars to reign by good luck." If you believe in Nostradamus' prophecies, here are some that he made for the year 2019. You can come back to this video next year and check if they actually came true. According to the interpreters of his work, Nostradamus predicted floods would hit Europe, particularly Hungary, Italy, the Czech Republic, and Great Britain. This and massive hurricanes and earthquakes in the US would be the result of global warming. But it's not all gloom and doom. He also wrote that there will be advances in medicine to extend people's lives and possibly a new global language. He also predicted that pigs will become brothers to man. Perhaps he meant that people will stop eating meat? I guess we can only speculate. And the Golden State Warriors will repeat as NBA champions. No, I made that up. So, do you think Nostradamus could really see the future, or just all those dollar signs? Let me know down below. Remember to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe to stay on the bright side of life.